making me blush. I feel the same way, though.
How so?
At least you had something in mind when you enrolled. My decision to come here was half-hearted at best. But I know now that it was the right choice. If I hadn't joined this academy, I never would have met you or any of our other classmates.
Rain.
Besides, you and I have something even closer than our other classmates. We're both followers of the Way of the Sword, and we keep pushing each other beyond our limits. I'm grateful for that.
As am I. And I suppose that's enough for now. Don't worry, it's nothing. I'm glad that the two of us have another year to train alongside each other.
Likewise. After that, I went back to see Elise. But by then, that memorable evening was approaching its end.
Rain? Elise? Claire?
Good evening, Captain. You must be exhausted.
Well, it's not as though I performed on stage in front of an auditorium full of people or anything. I really enjoyed your concert, by the way. That's the kind of thing that makes me proud to be an alumnus.
Wait, what? You're a student here?
That's right. I was part of the Academy's 216th graduating class. And since you'll be part of its 221st, I suppose that makes me 5 years your senior.
I had no idea. Why didn't you mention it until just now?
Given that we only ever met while you were on your field studies, it didn't seem pertinent. Besides, once people graduate, they tend to leave their ties to their school behind. Especially here at Thor's.
Because it's a military academy?
Exactly. Roughly 40% of the graduates here go on to join the military. Not always the same branch or even the same army. About 30% join the Imperial Army, and 10% go to a provincial force. Students who are best friends one day might find themselves enemies the next. Kill your happy mood like this. But I'm sure you're well aware of what may lie ahead. That we're teetering on the brink of an era of upheaval.
I'm aware.
Does this have something to do with the issues in Crossbell I've been hearing about?
Yes, amongst other things. It seems as though everyone on the continent is ready to go to war with everyone else. That's why it's so important that we're able to stand strong no matter what happens. Though, judging by how well Class 7 has performed on their field studies, I'm sure you'll all be fine in that regard. Here's hoping that I get the chance to help you out again sometime. Even if I'll have to be careful not to draw the ire of that instructor of yours while I'm doing so.
I'm just glad to know that you have her back. Thank you for that.
You're quite well. Please, excuse me a moment. Yes, Revelt speaking. What? And you're certain of this? Understood. I'll return at once. Yes, I will escort them back to Valflame Palace myself. I'm afraid I have to excuse myself.
Sorry, Elise. My brothers requested that we return to Heimdall right away. But as we're going back by car, I thought I'd offer you a ride home.
I think you should go back with them for now. I'll call you later to make sure you're okay.
Well, all right.
Sorry to drop this on you so quickly, Rin. I'm sure someone from the Academy will fill you in shortly. Fill me in? On what?
If you'll excuse us.
Sure to get Elise back to the Academy safely.
Does anyone have any idea what's going on?
I'm afraid not. I've never seen Father behave like that before.
My mother's the same way. She got a message of some kind and just changed.
Ditto my father. I think it was someone from Heimdall who got in touch with him.
One thing is certain. Something terrible has happened.
My dad turned pale and was gone before I could ask what happened. It sounded like he received a report from Instructor Neidhart, though.
Hold on. Neidhart's supposed to be... He was at Corellia Fortress with the 4th Armored Division on some sort of mission, right?
Speaking of which, has anyone seen Toa or Instructor Sarah?
Students and visitors. I cannot thank you enough for your attendance today. I hereby proclaim the 127th Thor's Military Academy Festival complete. But I am afraid I must announce this with a heavy heart, as we have just received word from the Imperial Government that this evening, Gorellia Fortress, which rests on the eastern border of the Empire, has been destroyed. No, destruction is an inadequate word. An unknown weapon has erased the fortress in its entirety from existence. I would ask that all of our guests, from that region or otherwise, please try to remain calm.
Ah, I can't take this anymore! Where is she? Homeroom was supposed to start ages ago.
I'm not surprised she's late. The instructors are probably all busy trying to figure out what to do.
That seems more than likely. This morning's meeting has already blown past its normal ending time.
It's still hard for me to believe all of this is really happening. I haven't been there. The idea that Gorelia Fortress just vanished is difficult to comprehend.
Not all of it, I heard. There are still some parts left and almost untouched. But Instructor Neidhart making it out of there alive was nothing short of a miracle, though.
Those huge railway guns were part of the section that's gone, too. If I hadn't seen the pictures, it would be kind of hard to believe.
Weapon is even capable of doing something like that. I find myself doubtful that any human could create something so powerful.
We just don't know. All we do know is that it's impossible to make a weapon that powerful even with today's most advanced orbital technology.
And yet here we are, with just such a weapon in the hands of what's always been seen as a mere vassal state. The Imperial Army has their work cut out for them, I'll say that much.
I'm worried about what's going on in the capital, too. It sounds like there have been even more demonstrations going on there these past few days.
Down with Crossbell, they say. Point our guns towards the east.
Is there even any truth to those rumors that Califord's planning an invasion?
I'm pretty sure it's all nonsense. But considering how there have been tensions between us and them for years, people are just more inclined to believe it. Rumors are just that. We need to be careful not to be misled by half-truths and speculation. If possible, we should find out exactly what's happening for ourselves.
Yeah. Over the year, we've seen how things are across the Empire with our own eyes. Now's as good a time as any to put that knowledge to use.
Well said. We've had quite the education in getting to the truth behind all the headlines.
That seems to have been a running theme of most of our field studies.
Still, we seem to be missing two of our illustrious members.
Well, there's nothing strange about Crow's habitual truancy. Did he already transfer back to his original class?
No. He said he was going to be with us through the end of the month. Is Vermilion, though? I'm not sure.
You don't think it's something to do with the Intelligence Division, do you?
Well, she is an agent of theirs.
It's kind of easy to forget that, given how she usually is.
It does concern me that none of us have seen her.
Sorry to keep you waiting.
Oh, instructor.
Are we starting homeroom?
Not today, I'm afraid. All classes have been canceled. You can either stay here in the building and study until school's out, or go back to the dorm.
So, wait.
Has something happened?
Not yet, but it will. Chancellor Osborne's going to be addressing the nation from Draco's Plaza at noon. It's set to be broadcast across the entire Empire.
Address?
Sounds pretty serious, and given the timing.
Indeed, it's not hard to imagine what's on his agenda.
Come on, guys, straighten up. You're students of Thor's Military Academy, and that makes you all cadets. Whatever careers you choose, military or civilian, you need to know how to act decisively in an emergency. So right now, I don't want you to look away from what's happening in the world. I want you to face it straight.
Will do.
You're right. Now's not the time to lose heart.
As for Osborne's speech, apparently we'll be setting up radios in each classroom so the students can listen to the national address. So if you want to follow along, be sure to be back here by noon.
I suppose I might as well listen to it here, then.
Same here. I don't even have a radio.
I do, but for something like this, I'd rather not listen to it alone.
Well, then, we can all share in the joy of hearing the melodious voice of our esteemed Chancellor.
Maybe I should haul in some beer and snacks. It's the only way I'll stay sane through the entire broadcast.
What should we do about Crow and Milliam, though? None of us have seen either of them all day.
Do you know where they are?
Can't say I do. Crow's practically made a career out of playing hooky, but I did see Milliam earlier this morning.
Oh, so she's still on campus?
At least that means she wasn't called away by the Intelligence Division.
I'd been thinking along those lines, but when I asked her, she just shrugged and said, "No news from the top!" I doubt she's wandered off too far.
Yes, but lest you forget, she excels at giving us the runaround.
At least it doesn't sound like she's in trouble. We're probably worried over nothing.
We'll just have to tell them we're meeting here at noon if we run into them before then.
Yeah, we'll do.
I guess everyone's going to check in with their clubs. Looks like I have some free time. Might as well see if I can track down Crow and Milliam. At least it sounds like Milliam is probably somewhere on campus. Crow, though, he could be anywhere. Probably best to check with Toa and George first. Maybe they know something.
Thank you. Thank you.
Right. 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 Right.